ధ్వా గణపతి గుం హవామహే కవిం కవీనాముపమశ్రవస్తమం జ్యేష్ఠరాజం బ్రహ్మణాం బ్రహ్మణస్పత ఆనశ్రన్వన్నోతిభిస్సేదసాదనం ఓం శ్రీ మహాగణాధిపతయే నమో నమః. ఓం సర్వమంగళమాంగళ్యే శివే సర్వార్థసాధికే శరణ్యే త్ర్యంబకే గౌరీ నారాయణి నమోస్తుతే. జయ నారాయణి నమోస్తుతే. శ్రీనారాయణి నమోస్తుతే. ఓం బ్రహ్మాదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః. సర్వోప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన గణ ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. My best wishes and blessings to all the viewers of Sri Venkateswara Bhakthi Channel, and my prayer to the Almighty Venkata Chalapati to bestow all kinds of prosperity, good health and wealth and eternal happiness to entire your family members and you and your friends. Srimad Bhagavadgeeta, verse number 26 of second chapter. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Atha Chainam Nitya Jatam Nityam Vamanya Semrutam Tatha Pitvam Mahabaho Naivam Shochitam Arhasi. Life is endowed with coffee psychology. Do you know what the coffee psychology is? When you have a first sip of a drop of a coffee, what the experience that we have, that bitterness. And you said, what, this is something different taste. As day grows and month grows, then you become habitual, finally you become addicted to that coffee. In the same way, when first time your parent, especially your father, comes to your ear and says, Raghav, 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 and you will be blinking because something strange is heard, then so many things, so many materials, so many people, so many knowledge around, everything was introduced, and you were introduced your name, you were not confused. When you were introduced so and so son like, you are not confused, and you are not confused with all the character which you were playing without beginning the consciousness enough to realize that you are an individual. Because up to 4 or 5 years old, you may not have that I am an individual, I should take care of myself. That notion of taking care of myself, it begins slowly. When it begins, a fear also gets into our psychological system. There is a fear already, but that fear gets a complete form. Now Arjuna, when Krishna told, you are nothing but inconceivable, inexpressible, unnameable Atma, and all-pervasive one. Immediately, you know, it was amazing, at the same time shocking too. Because Arjuna had amazed by having the experience in the first time in his life. And he was shocked too. And also seeing the Krishna, he became more amazed, because never ever Krishna spoke like this. He felt himself as a strange person. Just he was looking and blinking. Blinking the eyes, because what Krishna says is entirely new. And we are also blinking the eyes when it is said that you are a deathless person. Oh, am I a deathless person? Maybe. So what? Why so what? I am a deathless person, but I am also going to leave my body. So what? And what the benefit I will get out of this knowledge? And there are people, you know, they won't accept the conclusion of the Shastra. There is an Atma which gives space for all elemental world. They don't accept. They say that this body has the consciousness. Of course, we are accepting it. But that consciousness, you don't say that consciousness is the cause of this body. No, I cannot accept. I am a samsari, I am a body fellow. I am nothing but the sharira. This dehoham buddhi never leaves us after even studying. This is like, you know, when you look at the sky. If I ask you what is the color of the sky, immediately you will say that blue in color, sir. Oh, of course, very good. But science says there is no color for the sky. Science says because of the dust, it reflects the sun rays, it appears as though blue, sometimes orange, sometimes yellow, and sometimes rainbows. Once you come to know that the reality, the sky doesn't have color, your buddhi will say there is no color, but your mind and eyes will confirm it is in blue color. In the same way, when Shastra says you are deathless, birthless, and you are modificationless, vikara rahitaha, your buddhi may accept, but your mind still won't accept. In that buddhi too, there is one portion called, which is endowed with logical approachment. It will be keep on bugging your mind, Arjuna's mind also. In the same way, it was not able to digest the knowledge which was unfolded by Krishna. Now that is important. Any knowledge, it has to be digested. What do I mean by digesting? Digestion means you need to be endowed with that knowledge. It will take its own time to get, you know, identified. Not for all, okay? Not for all. If you are a proper adhikari, adhikari means a proper qualified one for Vedanta, so in the first shot itself, you will be settled as Atma, Aham Brahmasmi. That's very difficult, very rare. But here, Arjuna, who had already confused, who is endowed with a fluctuated mind, for him it was little bit difficult to digest immediately. If it would have been in the courtyard or somewhere else, or in the somewhere any other occasion, it would have been okay for Arjuna. But here it is in the battlefield, and he wants to escape, he wants to run away, desperately he wants to run away from the battlefield. Though he has surrendered Lord Krishna, he was not ready completely to accept the knowledge which was unfolded by Lord. Then Krishna thinks, oh, chalo, let us step down, one step down. He says, atha yenam nitya jatam mṛtam manyase. If you think this ātmā, it also gets birth and death, doesn't matter. Even in that case, you need not worry. This is not the teaching. This is the teaching means what? It is hitting in the same ball to Arjuna. Because Arjuna's mind is endowed with a doubt now. That doubt won't go because there is no medicine for the doubt. In the vichara, vichara means Vedanta provides the space to have doubts. And people also will say that any religion, because the Vedanta is not against any religion, it accepts all the religions. But when it comes the matter about Atma, Vedanta is very solid and careful because it establishes Atma is nothing but Brahman in different way, you cannot deny it. Now here it provides the space for questions from Shishya, from the disciple, because his experience is completely ulta, means opposite what Shastra says. Because my experience, not only mine, your experience also, it confirms you are endowed with body. If you want to separate yourself from the body, it's a very difficult job. For the thousands of janma, we have become habitual for it. Within a janma, is very difficult. Though it is very difficult, but it's very easy. So because you may have 10,000s of year in a room, I mean the darkness which exists for thousands of years, it was locked, kept locked. If you want to drive the darkness away, you take a little bit, means a small ethnic lamp, the dark vanishes. In the same way, when you hear that you are not body, mind and sense complex, you are Atma, that it hits, though you are not able to accept completely, that hits. Therefore, Krishna didn't think that his teaching went vain. No, he has given the dose, and he doesn't want to stick with that because no time, Guru and Shishya were not having time, they were in the battlefield. Therefore what? Krishna hits once again, having stepping himself down the next level. If at all you think you are endowed with death, because whatever it dies, it comes back again. Any product which we use, we are habitual of seeing manufacturing date and that expiry date too. Therefore what? Body has the expiry date, doesn't mean it's not a problem at all. But the problem is, when I understand Atma is Nityam, there it's difficult. If I want to understand myself as who is undergoing the death, it's not the problem at all. Let us accept the Atma dies, but it will come back again because we are in between. So this logical approach, every creature can understand this small amount of understanding. Because when I was born, I will die definitely. When I will achieve death, there is going to be one more beginning, because this ending cannot be the proper ending. That understanding we get when we love somebody, that you know, very near and dearest people, when they die, the mind won't accept it. You will definitely say that they are existing in some other form. It cannot vanish because you experience the proximity of their consciousness. You could able to communicate with the consciousness. Though you are living physically, you were living physically with them, but you used to connect with their consciousness. That understanding will exist in our mind. Therefore, Krishna was very confident. He is very confident to give this kind of teaching. Though it is against Vedanta, Because few people think that this tarkikas means there was a school of thought of people. They used to think that Atma is non-eternal. Atma means the body has got the consciousness. The consciousness goes with the body. When again body comes, the consciousness becomes alive. That is the concept. If at all you think that way, doesn't matter, because there is a rules. That rules is said here, Jatasya hi dhruvo mrityuhu dhruvam janma mrutasya cha tasmada pariharyarthe natvam shochitum arhasi. Whatever dies means, so whatever the object, it goes into unmanifested form. The death, no word in our Shastra which means that everything goes completely vanishes. No. It says the death, death means maranam. Maranam. Ranam means dukkham. So that sorrowless. When people die, they become relaxed. Something is relaxed. Something is removed. Something is released. Therefore, whatever the departure take place, that's what the word used by Shastra, then there is going to be one more arrival in the airport. Like in the airport. When you go to the airport, there is a way to arrival part and way for departure. In the same way, the life has got both departure and arrival. Now, arrival has taken place. Again, the departure, we are waiting for the departure. After that, we should wait for arrival. Jatasya hi dhruvoh mrityuh. Certainly, there is going to be death once you are born. And the same way, so again, when you are achieving death, again you will come back as a birth. You will be born again. Tasmad aparihariye arthe natum shochitum arhasi. In that case, even you need not to worry. That's what Krishna's solid message by this two verses. The next verse. Avyaktadini bhutani vyaktamadhyani bharata avyaktanidhanan eva tatraka paridevana. Now Krishna uses a different language. Okay? This language from the aspects of creation. Because we believe there is a creation. Yes, I am alive. Therefore, there should be the creation. Therefore, we fix so many theory on the creations. Some people say that Big Bang theory is the theory. Some people said that evolution happened from monkeys, slowly we came like. And some people say that it is like different particles, and it accumulated so many concepts. And Upanishad also talks about the creation, but in different way. It says that creation means what? This is in your experience, you become manifested when you wake up. Then you go into unmanifested when you sleep. Manifestation, unmanifestation. Now, manifestation is called Vyaktaha, the stage which has Nama Rupa. Coming into being means what? Coming into Nama and Rupa. That's what is known as manifestation, called creation. Avyaktadini Bhutani. These all creatures, they were in the form of unmanifested state. Then they come into manifest, then they go into unmanifestation again. That is the Upanishadic view. He says here, avyaktadini bhutani, bhutani avyaktadini vyaktam adhyani bharata. They were in unmanifested form, now they are manifested. Again they will go to unmanifested form. It's a circle. Therefore, when you kill these people, definitely they will come again. You need not to worry, Arjuna. You just need not worry for your death too. So Krishna has slowly started penetrating his life. Because when you think, so I was in the unmanifested form, how? Because when you were born from the womb. Before that womb, were you there or not? Because when we come out, then alone people say that the baby is born. But baby was there inside with conscious. That consciousness is not understood. So when you come out, sensory organs, they work. So when they work, you realize yourself with limitations. Before going into mother's womb, we were in the sharira of our father. Even not in the sharira of the father, Patanjali says, in the thought process. When they had, yes, let us have a baby. That is the garbha. You know, that garbha, before that you are endowed with Hiranya garbha. That is the language Upanishad speaks. You were in the cosmos. Then you penetrated. Means what? You penetrated in your father and mother's mind as the thought process. Then you started working grossification, with the grossification. From thought to blood, from blood to... So all this process, you are very clear about it. Then what? When we manifest. Then when we go into unmanifested form, again you will be manifesting definitely. That is the secret. This secret, when you hear the secret, because the body is a marvelous functioning machine, you know, this is the wonder. If you could see what is going on in the body, definitely you will be shocked and amazed. The body is a wonder. Every cell has got its own capacity because the entire body has come from one cell. That's how we need to understand our sharira. I am deathless. I was. That not the point. I was. We were. Everyone, he was in the form of unmanifestation. Then we manifest. We are born. Now we are born, but we will go into unmanifestation. Again we will come back. Therefore what? Death comes and goes, and birth comes and goes, but I will witness. Like if day comes and go, and night comes and goes. In the same way. So thousands of minsa, crores of days comes and goes. They come and go. Like night also come and go, I become a victim. Like so many bodies, they come and go, doesn't matter. So you remain Arjuna. Arjuna means every one of us, all of us are nothing but Arjuna. We remain, we are Shashvata Atma alone. Therefore, we have to have this assimilating process. Let us continue with this process from tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.